Yo, 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 what's up, guys, and welcome back to my channel, Sarah Marguerite. So, this video is a draw my life, even though I cannot draw, so don't come for me, okay? Okay. So, on May 31st, 1996, I was born to my father named Emil and my mom, who is Stacy. And I was born in the city of Philly, hey, and look at that janky behind Liberty Bell. So then on April 18th, 1998, I became a big sister for the first time because my sister Ayana was born. And then I became an even bigger sister on May 16th, 1999 because my sister Andrea was born. And from that point on, we were known as the Stanton Girls. So then I turned 4 and it was time to go to pre-K. And I went to Charity Head Start. And I have a crazy story. So, like, overall, I loved my preschool. But, y'all, one day they served us coleslaw, right? I don't like coleslaw, never have, don't like the way that it looks, none of that. And I didn't want to eat it. So, they tried to force me to eat it, and I didn't eat it. So, that meant that I wasn't eating lunch. So, they called my mom, bruh. And she had to come, and they were trying to, like, get her to make me eat it. So she came, and I really had to eat it. And I think that I either threw it back up, or I am not sure what happened. But to this day, I cannot eat coleslaw, bro. Ugh. That really, really, really traumatized me. So we are just going to fast forward. So when I was about 9 or so, maybe a little bit even younger than that, my dad became a pastor of a church in West Philadelphia, and we became pastor's kids. Woo! I can do a whole nother video on just that by itself. Don't want to get into that right now. So then from that point on, people started to figure out that my dad was a pastor. So at school, they'd be like, oh, is your dad a pastor? And I'd be like, no, no, he isn't, because I was ashamed. So then in the 5th grade, I developed a speech impediment called a stutter. Yeah, so that was very, very hard. And then when I was in the 6th grade, as most of you know, I had to give a presentation in class, and the only words that I could get out was my project, so I failed that project. And I was getting teased a lot because of my speech impediment, and I was put into a very dark place. Yeah, like, it just wasn't good. I was very, very depressed, and I was having all of these thoughts about, like, suicide and things like that, which is nothing to play with, and it just felt like a dark cloud was just over me, and I was just kind of listening to like a lot of, like, bands and stuff that people now would be like, what, like, you listen to those groups? Yeah, I was obsessed. My favorite one was Paramore. I loved some Paramore, okay? I used to just be very, very, like, depressed and stuff. Not fun. I went to the Philadelphia High School for Girls, otherwise known as Girls High, and I was a class of 258. And when I first got there, ugh, I hated it so much. Like, I hated it. I never, like, wanted to actually go there. I actually wanted to go to a performing arts school called Kappa, but my dad decided that I was gonna go to girls high. I don't even think that he remembers, but yeah, he was the reason that I had to go there. I hated it. But then I finally saw that I could join the choir, and then I was like, oh, I really enjoy choir. So yeah, like I have an actual reason to just come here like every day. So then I got my acceptance letter to Westchester University, and I was so happy because that was my first choice. Ah! And then I graduated. Thank the Lord. See you never. LOL. Then it was move-in day, and I had to move into my dorm and leave my family behind. And I was trying to pretend that I didn't care, but on the inside, I was definitely going to miss my family. And my mom was like super, super sad. Yep, and then I was living the college life as a freshman with a whole bunch of friends that I thought were like my actual friends. Yep, it was me and my squad. And I was actually talking to this boy that I thought was like the love of my life. But anyway, so then things happened and it just kind of took a turn, and I lost a lot of the people that I thought I was so close to. And then the guy that I was talking to started playing games. and he didn't want to talk to me no more. So yeah, I didn't know who the heck I was. And then I began to take gospel choir more seriously, and that's where I met my best friend, Aaliyah. Hey, Lily. So then, y'all, when I was a sophomore, I had me a little boyfriend or whatever. Alright, let me calm down. But I had me a boyfriend, and I was in love with him, okay? And nobody could tell me nothing about this boy, because I was going to marry him. Anyway, we started posting stuff on like Instagram and Snapchat and things like that, and people started to call us goals. And then when I was a junior, I was still in a relationship, and because me and my boyfriend broke up, and then we got back together when I was a junior. Oh my gosh. But I was living with my best friend in this apartment, and it was Liddy, Liddy, Liddy. So then, when I was a senior, me and my boyfriend officially broke up for the last time, and that joint, I was devastated. But yeah, I completely lost myself, so I had to find myself again. So we're gonna fast forward. So it just took a lot of prayer and just kind of focusing on me, but I began to find out who I was, and I love who I have become and who I am becoming. And I was also focusing on Marguerite on the Beat, which is my makeup business and brand. And that was just like awesome, because I did my first ever photo shoot and it went so well, and I just was like definitely gaining like a whole bunch of like clients and stuff. So that is fantastic, and it's what I love to do. So fast forwarding, I am a college graduate and it's so lit, class of 2018, and yeah, to God be the glory. So what is next for the kid? I don't know. But that is why we have to stay tuned, because the rest is still being written. So So I want to thank you guys for watching this video. Please don't forget to like, comment, share, and also subscribe to this channel. I love you guys, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.